When observing perfect dark skies, the human eye may be able to detect several thousand stars. Unfortunately, in most major cities, the number of observable stars reduces to around 100 due to the dominating presence of artificial light pollution. Today, approximately 80% of the world's population live under a form of light pollution called sky glow. Sky glow brightens the sky overall, leading to a low contrast between skies and stars, so that they are very difficult to spot. For the tens of thousands of years prior to the light pollution of present day, the world's first astronomers were looking up upon pristine dark skies and forming a complex understanding of the ways they tell us about the land. Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander nations are the world's longest continuing cultures, with an oral history that has endured more than 65,000 years. Over this time, Indigenous astronomers have been making systematic observations of the skies and its objects. Through these observations, they have developed intricate knowledge systems which detail the many ways the skies may inform us about key processes on the land. The appearance and positioning of features in the sky may tell us about native animal and plant cycles, the state of our food sources, how to forecast weather events and seasonal variation, as well as guiding us in navigating across country and serving as a calendar for key ceremonial events. The oral tradition of many First Nations peoples means that they rely on non-written forms of communicating, storing, and transmitting information. Common forms of communication include storytelling, singing, dancing, and painting. Storytelling is a popular method for storing scientific observations in a format that can be flexibly retold. Most often, Aboriginal science is encoded into dreaming stories. Science is the pursuit of knowledge through systematic observations and experimentation. Although they are two distinct systems of knowledge, Indigenous and non-Indigenous methods of science are motivated by these same empirical values. Astronomers often conduct science through observation alone due to the unfathomably vast distances that lie in between stars of the Milky Way galaxy. It is not possible to transfer a star from the skies to a laboratory on Earth, so observation becomes the core foundation of astronomy. Indigenous astronomy calls upon a 65,000-year-old oral record of astronomical observations to inform scientific knowledge. Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander nations are the custodians of the world's longest continuous cultures. Their astronomical traditions may be the first forms of astronomy conducted worldwide. Through astrophysical and geological evidence, we can estimate the age of traditions relating to Indigenous astronomy. For example, stories that detail fire falling from the sky might be describing the impact of a meteorite on Earth. This is the case for traditions that describe the impacts at Tacha Kapara or Henbury Craterfield on the lands of the Arunda, Luritja, Pitanjara and Yunkajara communities. Geological evidence indicates that this crater site is at least 4,500 years old. Indigenous oral traditions also describe many historical events that have unfolded on timescales of millennia, like the precession of Earth's axis over 13,000 years, sea level rises that separated Tasmania from mainland Australia, and the eruption of volcanoes that permanently changed the landscape. Like that at the Budjbim cultural landscape over 38,000 years ago. Aboriginal science informs us of the long history of these lands, while also guiding us on our future engagement with country.
If you liked this video, you can find it and so many more at clickview.net. Sign up for free today.